Hello, I'm Andi, and I'm going to read to you a program called Tarot Monthly Horoscope for January 2019. And this is for you coming from Aries. First, let me quickly shuffle my Kabbalistic tarot cards and talk to you about the first 15 days of January, where your job or business or finances is concerned. And for you, this is a very difficult card. It says that the first 15 days of January are going to produce frustration because all planets are moving very slow for you. So you cannot expect any urgency in getting betterment in job or in business. Tell yourself it's playing a waiting game that's very important. You have some opportunity coming your way, off and on. But the finishing part is going to be the problem. So apply this rule to your job or business area in the first 15 days and say, play the waiting game, don't take risks, and try to definitely don't want to be rebellious or making life difficult for yourself with the people you do business with or the people you work with. Now I'm going to talk to you about the first 15 days regarding the romance and marriage area. Let's see what the card says. Well, it's a card that says finding a romance during the first 15 days of January is very possible, but it comes loaded with past issues that you will have to worry about. So this person who wants to come into your life in the form of a new romance is going to bring some complications. Be prepared for that. Your ongoing romance is going to find some opposites about you. So you got to be definitely to be helpful in keeping your ongoing romance happy in the first 15 days. There is frustration, there is news about things of the past that are going to upset you. Or it could be that it's your past activities that may upset your romance partner. One way or another, the romance seems to be 50-50, the good and the bad side. So work harder and you'll keep your romance happy. And if you are married, this is a horoscope that shows, this is a card that shows that all the views that you have, your marriage partner will look at it from the opposite angle. So don't try to be competitive with your marriage partner. Be understanding that there is a lot of issues in your marriage where the opposite points of view are being looked at. And because of that, since it's you who is listening to me, be accommodating with your marriage partner and your romance partner, and situations will improve. Now I'm going to go to your last 15 days of January, and I'm going to talk to you about your job and business areas. And this is an even worse card. This card says that expect in your job unexpected differences and problems that can give you a danger of even losing the job. So you have to work very much harder. Don't try to oppose those who are in charge at your job, or you will find that problems come, especially if you behave in a rebellious way. And also past difficulties that you have in your job can be also used to give you trouble. I'm going to use the same card for your business side. And it says basically you can lose a business agency, or you can lose very badly in business in the last 15 days of January. So it looks like the whole month in business you got your back to the wall. So you mustn't be adventurous looking for new businesses. You'll be just getting into water that's too deep for you. Just consolidate and look after what you have in these last 15 days, or even that business is just going to break down in some area or another. So that's the problem now that you have in the last 15 days, where your job and business is concerned, is all moving uphill for you, struggling. Try your best to keep going. And now I'm going to pull this card for the last 15 days of January to do with your romance or your marriage areas. Well, it's another card of somehow problems. It says it's a never-ending rhythm of problems from you and your romance partner. And if I apply this card to finding a new romance, I would say that there is going to be a lot of frustration for you. There's a runaround for you. there's all the upsets waiting if you find a new partner. So if you do find a new partner, if you want that partner very much, tell yourself you have to give a lot. And if you have an ongoing partner, it's, as I said, ongoing differences of opinion and trouble. One of you is going to behave very rebelliously and threateningly. So since it's you listening to me, and if you value your romance, don't do that. And if your romance partner does behave that way, then if you want the romance to go on, well, just try to be as calm as possible. And if you are married with this card, I will worry that past issues are coming to trouble you very much. And whatever you do in these last 15 days, don't argue with anybody. And there's some issue about spending as well. There's going to be a very sore point between you and your marriage partner. So the whole month of January, whether it's job, whether it's business, whether it's any area, is going to be a problem. Now I'm going to use the Kabbalistic cards to talk to you about your lucky ages to help you, you coming from Aries. And so, well, this card says that in the month of January, if you happen to be the ages of 18 or 27 or 36 or 45 or 54 or 63 or 72, you're going to be one very lucky person, whether in the job, whether in the business, whether the romance or whether in the marriage. So you have an upper hold on being the lucky one. If you're not of these ages, you'll need to have a 90-minute session with me one day, which will cost you $50 to know your next 7, 8 or 9 years. We'll talk more about that later. Now I'm going to pull another card to talk to you about your lucky dates, D-A-T-E-S, your lucky dates in the month of January. And wow, this is a very powerful card, and it says that the 3rd, the 12th, the 21st and the 30th of January are going to produce many opportunities for you, whether in job, business, whether in romance, and to improve the marriage as well, or to improve your finances in general. So bookmark these dates, morning, afternoon, noon and night, and go all out to do what you want, and you will benefit a lot. Now I'm going to look at the next card to tell you what best color to wear to bring a lot of luck for yourself. And oh, it's the color of Mars, which means the color red. So I would like you to wear a lot of red as much as possible during the month of January. Undergarments, top garments, try to handle red, a red handkerchief, anything like that, and you will benefit with that universal energy that will come for you to bring you good luck, the color red. And now I'm going to look at your lucky directions. There will be always a certain direction, because every of the 9 planets has been put round the compass. And so for you, for the month of January, another card of Mars. So I would say, if you face south as much as possible, whether in your office, whether at home, try to face the direction south as much as possible. You are going to get that added good energy to overcome the difficulties of January. So keep that in mind. Well, that's what I have to tell you, you coming from Aries, using the tarot, Kabbalistic tarot cards, and I wish you the best of luck. If you want to have a session with me for 90 minutes, it'll cost you $50. I will tackle your next 7, 8 or 9 years, and I will be able to give you information about all areas of your life, even your personal lucky lottery numbers, your lucky days, your lucky gemstones, your lucky directions, a lot of good news. So I'm going to give you my email address to contact me, and my email address is andihoro9, andihoro9, the number 9, at gmail.com, andihoro9@gmail.com, and I hope to receive a message from you so that I can answer it. Until then, I wish you the best of January 2019. Thank you and goodbye.